crispydelight.com and today I'm going to show you. So we have our kheer that we made earlier and now we're going to make the dosa. So I'm going to take a little amount into the bowl, and since this is a little bit thicker than I want, so I'm going to add a little bit of water, just a little bit. So now I'm going to show you how you can pour the batter onto the tawa. The tawa should be cold, it shouldn't be hot, because you need a time to spread out the dosa properly. The surface of the tawa should not be hot, it should be the room temperature, or you know, you can just sprinkle cold water, running water from the tap, and you can just make the surface cold if it's too hot. And now I'm going to pour a little bit of oil. This is optional. If you don't want too brown, then you can skip the spreading out the oil. See how the edges has already coming out. So the already brown on the one side, I'm going to show you how it looks like. You can make it according to your preference. If you like more brown, then you can make it more brown. This is how it looks like, but we don't need to cook on the other side. So you can just cook a little bit on the other side. And now I'm going to put the filling, the potato sabji. And we're going to roll it over. So our dosa is ready. So I'm going to make now rest of the dosas. Now I'm going to show you how you can make the cheese dosa as well. Sprinkle some yellow cheese. And some white cheese. Or whatever cheese you like. And we're going to let the cheese melt. So the side has already got brown. So this is our cheese dosa ready.